Yeah, just go with Oddish first, see what happens. This looks like it's going to be a hiker, so he'd be good against those, because they typically carry rocks, geodudes, and stuff like that. And what do we got? We got a Machop, actually. They also, yeah, they typically carry geodudes and Machop, sometimes Zubats, I think. But I can probably, I should be able to take that with the some absorbs here. That shouldn't be very effective, but it is. Or, yeah, what the hell? I have poison, that should be not very effective. I still don't know how that works in red-blue. Yeah, I stand no chance here. I'm definitely, well, that was a critical hit, so I'm gonna take a risk and try to put it to sleep. If I miss, I'm gonna switch. Okay, I hit it. Sweet. And a first turn wake. That's wonderful. Now I think I'm gonna die. Unless I can try to land it again. I'm thinking here if I wanna try to land another one. Switch out. Oh man, I wish I was doing a Nuzlocke right now. I should talk about that. I am gonna switch out though. To the Pidgey. You know, I probably shouldn't be going to Pidgey Island either. Because it's, you know, it's fine as far as level goes too. But, not very, yeah, that's just so weird how effectively it works, because I'm half flying, half, I don't know, like, which type it chooses, maybe, like, the first type, maybe my primary type is flying, because fighting is not very effective in flying, but super effective in its normal, which is what Pidgeotto is, it's half flying, half normal, so, I don't know, and then, that was, no, it's neutral effective that Karate Chop, so that's really strange in how that works. Because one fighting move was not very effective, that was Low Kick, and then Karate Chop was neutrally effective. So I don't know, I really don't get it. Okay, Onix, nothing that Pidgeotto can do about that, so I'm gonna go back to the Oddish, try to get some health back, that'd be a good opportunity. Onix should be no problem to take out with Oddish. Hoping to get enough HP back that, oh well, it's faster. How is it faster? Is Oddish really that slow? I didn't think I'd be outsped by an Onix there. Okay, yeah, well. But still didn't have any troubles taking it out, so. Cool, cool. But anyway, I was talking about Nuzlocke, and if you don't know what Nuzlocke is, it's a really cool concept. It took me a long time to actually discover it. Apparently, it's been around for a while. What a Nuzlocke challenge is where you actually, it's like a self-imposed hard mode of a playthrough of Pokemon. And what it basically is, I don't know the full rules. I might have to look it up again to give you like the full rules on it. Maybe I'll put it in the description. But what it basically is that whenever you lose a Pokemon, like whenever one of your Pokemon faints, then they're dead, they're done, you can't use it anymore, you have to put it in like a graveyard box in your PC. So that, oh wow, I wasn't really paying attention to that, evolved at 21. Yeah, I was just going to evolve to its second form, Gloom. And it has three forms. His third form is Vileplume, it evolves into that with the Leaf Stone, which we'll be getting much later in the game. But anyway, yeah, so whenever your Pokemon faint, they are dead, you can't use them anymore, and you just have to put them away in a graveyard box. And, let's put Jazzy back in front. And, so that makes the game a whole lot tougher and a whole lot more exciting to play. It's something I never actually tried, but I'd imagine it to be a lot more exciting. I've been watching Cooper, a YouTube channel that's been doing a blind Nuzlocke, which is a first time playthrough without any information of the game prior to playing. A blind Nuzlocke, white, same thing, basically the same thing. And it's actually pretty exciting to watch, because he has to go without having his Pokemon die. And then whenever something does die, then it's actually pretty tragic, and it And you know, I imagine myself the way I get attached to my Pokemon, and I'm sure all players do get attached. And it's like, wow, that's, you know, like imagine how devastating it'd be to you if your starter died like really late in the game, like your starter Pokemon died, and then you couldn't use it anymore. So that's something that I've been considering doing now, and I really wish I would have known about that before I did this game. Otherwise, I probably would have done a Nuzlocke of this game. And I have been told by other people that I should, like, change it to a Nuzlocke halfway through or something like that, but, yeah, then that'd throw people off, and I'm not gonna do that. As much as I would like to, I really would love to do a Nuzlocke of a Pokemon game. I'm not sure if it'd be this one. This would be a tough game to Nuzlocke, this first one. Just because, critical hits seem to happen a lot more often, and, also, it'd be really annoying managing your death box. I mean, that wouldn't be a big deal, because you wouldn't have to use it that often if you're careful enough. I mean, knowing me, I'd probably have to revisit that graveyard box a lot. But I don't know, I mean, that would really make you into a better player, too. It makes you more conservative, a lot smarter with how you use your moves, that'd probably teach you more of the strategy aspect of battling, instead of just, you know, randomly clicking the moves and not caring if something dies and using death fodder, because, you know, in a Nuzlocke, death fodder is really not an option, because you cannot afford to have things die. So it's something that I'm really interested in trying, because I don't, you can only play through these games so many times without getting bored of the concept, and I admittedly am starting to find the concept stale. Like, when I played through Black, it was fun, it was neat, but, it was still the same old game over again, just new Pokemon, that's basically it. By the way, here's a new Pokemon, if you've seen it. Beedrill, this is the final form of Weedle and Kakuna. And it is a bug poison type, at least it should be poison. Let's see if I get a super effective hit on it. I don't understand how dual types really work in this game. That was super effective. So, he does have his poison half here. And I would guess he also has his bug half. Fury attack, that's a normal move, I'm guessing. Isn't there another one? Fury Cutter is on this bug. And level 21, awesome. So let's just get dig up to 21. I'll switch it out. Yeah, switch it out. Now let's see this. Let's see if I get a neutral hit with dig, because ground is super effective against poison, and it's not very effective against bug. Therefore, it should be neutral against Beedrill. So let's see. That was super effective, so that's really interesting. I don't understand. I don't know if it's primary type or what. I really don't know how this works. But whatever, I'll take it. It's just so inconsistent. I mean, I am glad they fixed it. Like, games makes it a little less confusing. Because I do not know what type combinations factor into type effectiveness or what. It makes this game a lot more confusing than it is now. That's pretty funny. Okay, there's just wild grass there. I don't care about that. How are we doing on health? I haven't really been keeping track. Everything is up to 21. I could just set the bar higher and put Charmeleon up in front. I don't know. I don't know if I should go heal and try to catch everyone up. That's what I'm thinking of doing. Let's fight something else. I'll keep him on front just for now, just because I don't know what this guy's gonna send out first. So I'm gonna. Oh, he has bug, guys. Let's see if he has another Beedrill and see if I can use fire against him. I would assume I would. Like, you know, for it to be super effective. Yeah, Caterpie. That should be a problem. Just a hook a Ember this, quick hook of that. And let's just switch out. I want to try to catch stuff up a little more, so let's go to Drowsy. Well, you know, I should start carrying potions with me a lot more. That way I can just heal myself when I'm in the middle of a route and have to go all the way back to the Pokemon Center. Because I do want to heal up and kind of get back in shape soon. I mean, I'm not too worried right now, but I don't remember how many trainers are on the way there, on the way to the Rock Tunnel, which is where we're on our way to get to right now. I'm gonna switch out. Venonat's a new Pokemon that we haven't seen yet, bug type, and I'll go with Pidgeotto here. I don't have a bug or a flying move, but either way, it's not a big deal. Gust is supposed to be flying, but it's not. So I'll just spam Quick Attack. Alright, we see the bug catcher. All that was just quick attack, tackle. Nothing really all that interesting. Do a little bit of cutting there, and I was gonna switch to Oddish there, because I thought it was gonna be a hiker. I guess I was confused. I saw the black hair and thought hiker. Looks like it's just one of those junior trainer things. So I'm gonna take out this guy, and then I'm gonna go to the Pokemon Center and heal. So let's just make quick work of this. I'm considering just going through this guy's Charmeleon, not really caring. Just make it go fast. I'm just getting some damage on the Quick Attack. Yeah, Diglett here, that's a good opportunity to go to Oddish and get some experience for him. I'm just so organized, keeping this stuff all neat and tidy. Oh, it's not Oddish anymore. Gloom. Sorry about that. First time we've seen Gloom's back sprite. You see all that aroma around him, those red dots. That's pretty cool. I can't wait to see how much damage Mega Drain does, because Absorb's doing pretty well right now. He's gonna dig me to see if it's super effective or not. Yeah, it is. Oh, it didn't do a whole lot. Really, really strange, because ground's supposed to be resisted by grass, which I am half grass, and then it's super effective in poison, so. I'm gonna be talking about that this whole time, because I don't know, it just baffles me how this type of effectiveness works in the first game. Okay, that was a Ekans. I wasn't really paying too much attention, but I... Yeah. Good time to get a Drowsy, for sure. And then we'll just spam Confusion. Nothing too scientific here. Yeah, walk a KO. And then we'll just go back to Oddish. Sandshrew. Okay. Not Oddish, it's Gloom. Get it right. Ugh. Okay, so that's easy to hit KO. Maybe I'll get full health there. I probably don't really have to worry about healing too much. I'm gonna check again. I mean, I know Drowsy's kind of getting down there, but other than that, I think I'm actually okay. Yeah, you know what, I'm just gonna keep going. Whatever.